Imagine you could bottle your sunshine, you could bottle your wind energy and ship it all around the world. That's the promise of hydrogen. We believe that there is no path to net zero that does not include hydrogen in some form. It is not a silver bullet, but it is a key contributor and enabler. We believe that hydrogen can make our world more sustainable, but also more secure and safer, and can bring about great benefits for our communities. I think it's an opportunity, and it will only turn into reality if we choose to act on it. As a little girl, I wanted to be two things, a teacher and a diplomat. And I think I'm very lucky because I get to do both. My name is Ivana Jemelkova, and I am the CEO of the Hydrogen Council. The Hydrogen Council is a global CEO-led coalition that brings together nearly 140 businesses and investors working together to unleash the power of hydrogen as a clean energy solution. I really believe in the power of humanity, in the power of problem solving, in the power of collaboration, and the Hydrogen Council and let's say the clean energy transition at large is exactly that place. Hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe. The wonderful thing about hydrogen is that it can be also used as a fuel. It can be used as a clean energy solution. So today, most hydrogen is produced using fossil fuels. That means on a life cycle basis, there are emissions. Now, importantly, when hydrogen is used, there are no emissions. So even today, at the point of use, hydrogen is zero emission. So really what matters is how we create that hydrogen, how we deploy it, and how we then take stock of its emissions from the beginning to the end. What we want to achieve is that the full life cycle is very low or zero emissions. That is the difference between clean hydrogen and the conventional kind of hydrogen that's been used for decades. The benefits of global trade in hydrogen and clean energy are enormous. There are parts of the economy that cannot be electrified, that simply cannot run on electrons. And that's exactly where hydrogen can help. Hydrogen can help decarbonize sectors of the economy that are out of reach for other solutions. When we scale clean fuels and start using them around the world, we have calculated that we could save 60 to 80 gigaton of emissions. If that doesn't sound like much, it's double the amount we produce every year from burning fossil fuels, from energy production. So today, the hydrogen conversation is a bit of a mess. We use words like green, clean, low emission, low carbon, sustainable, and we don't really understand each other. So really what we're talking about here is clean hydrogen. And we need to have absolute clarity on what we mean by that. How that hydrogen is produced, how the environmental and climate attributes of that hydrogen are defined, how we measure them, how we verify them, how we certify them, and how we bring them to the market. With that clarity, certainty, and trust, we can start trading. We can start moving hydrogen around. We can start importing, exporting, and we can really motivate investors to put money on the table. That is what will get the hydrogen system going. To set global standards, it's really all about the industry and governments coming together. When companies, businesses, governments, civil society, when we come together, we can really achieve formidable things. We will mutually recognize each other's information on the quality of hydrogen. And that is the foundation of the global ecosystem. We all work from the same technical specifications, and we all mutually recognize the receipts and the bills and the stamps. And that is the beginning of global hydrogen trade. The best way to create the future is to build it. Hydrogen is happening, the industry is walking the talk, and we are seeing an incredible, undeniable dynamic in terms of deployment and investment. We're now reporting the historically highest levels of committed capital, 75 billion, seven times more in just the last 4 years, and over 400 projects pass FID, so four times more in terms of projects. Investment is absolutely key here. We are building a whole new dimension of the global energy system. Whenever I talk about investment numbers in hydrogen, I get big eyes. Those seem like massive amounts of money. But the reality is that they are just drops in the ocean compared to what we spend on energy today. And what we spend on many other things today. You know how much America spends on Christmas? A trillion. Every year. We're talking about one Christmas. Consumer spending for one Christmas, buying us the way to deploying clean energy at that level. Look, if we want a sustainable future, we have to act like we want it. Oftentimes, we need to choose progress rather than perfection. We are at a difficult moment in the energy transition globally. In short, we are not on track. We are not on track. So the key question is, do we want an energy transition? Are we serious about our action on climate? Because if we are, we need to act like it. I'm a very pragmatic person. So when I hear the word hope, I look for evidence. And I know that I see evidence in the clean energy space. We have evidence. We have done this before. We as humanity have come together and solved some of the most difficult, complex international problems. So for me, it's not hope. For me, it's really that work, that opportunity to do something good. And I know that we can.